5 children. Today I am going to discuss about the problems which are in your exercise 2.4 related to the chapter triangles. Let us discuss one by one, which is the first question that it is in your exercise. Let's triangle similar to the triangle DEF and their area be respectively 64 cm and 121 cm square. If EF is equal to 15.4 cm, find the BC. Yes, when you observe this question, so you are going to, you have to recall the formula. Otherwise, the area of similar triangles, that theorem you have to recall. Based on that, after drawing the drawing like this, you can easily calculate the value of BC. See, you can observe the two pictures. I have written one ABC, the triangle, and another triangle is DEF. According to their suggestion, they are considered to be as a similar triangles, and they have given the area of a first triangle is 64 cm square and the second triangle is 121 cm square. And also one of the corresponding side of the triangle DEF, they have given 14.4 cm. So after knowing this, you can easily remember and you have to recall that that equation or the formula related to the area of similar triangles is equal to the ratio of the square of the corresponding side. That statement we have to recall. According to that, we have to write like this. And then when you substitute the values, you will get the answer BC is equal to 11.2 cm. Yes, I hope you have understood this one. Just we have to know the theorem related to area of a triangle, similar triangles related. Okay. Yes, let us discuss about the second question. In this question, the diagonals of the trapezium ABC with AB parallel to DC intersect each other at a point O. If AB is equal to 2CD, find the ratio of the triangle AOB and COD. That is the question they are asking here. And one thing they have given, ABC is a trapezium and where AB and DC are the parallel sides and they intersect at O. That means the diagonals intersect at O and when then AB is equal to 2CD. These are the information that they have given. Then what we have to find? We have to find the area of a triangles AOB and COD. So in order to get the answer, let us see, you have to recall, you have to draw a diagram based on the information that what they have given in the question. Okay, so after drawing that, it becomes very easy to understand and which triangle area we have to calculate AOB and DO, COD. Okay, and so what they have given, so according to that, so the data diagonals of the trapezium ABCD with parallel AB DC intersect each other at the point O. We have AB is equal to 2CD. This is the information that they have given, that we have to write, that is the given information as a data. Then according to the area of a triangles is equal to square of the ratios of square of corresponding side. That statement, no, we have to find out the area of these two triangles based on the information what they have given related to corresponding sides. Okay, now according to this diagram, if I have written like this and based on the area of triangles theorem, so like this, when you substitute the values of AB and DC, so you will get that. So there, and also while substituting that, we have to concentrate AB is equal to 2DC. Then you will get 4DC square. After squaring that, okay, 2DC, you will get 4DC square. And then DC, the same remaining like that, only you have to write it. Then it will get cancels. And you will come to know that 4 by 1, that means 4 is to 1. The area of a triangle AOB is 4 times bigger than the first triangle COD. So in this way you have to calculate the ratios of area of triangles when they are present in the trapezium, where two sides are parallel and the diagonal intersect at a point O. Okay, yes, let us discuss about the third question. So in this question, they have given one figure. ABC and DC are two equal triangles on the same base BC. So if AD intersect the BC at O, they show that the area of triangle AO ABC and the triangle DBC is equal to AO by DO. So similarly, the same theorem we have to recall. First we have to write what they have given. So then what, just one construction we have to do, that is AP perpendicular to BC and DM perpendicular to BC. If you do like this, you will get a clear picture. So and also based on that we can easily prove that one. Okay, yes, area of, already you know that area of a triangle is equal to half into base into height. So based on that, by using that formula and the area of a triangles theorem, so I have written like this, and then I have substituted there, half and half get cancels, BC and BC is a get cancels, because BC is common for both the triangles, that's why that I have considered as a base, and then that has get cancels out, and AP by DM it has becomes. So let us according to the diagram what we have constructed. So in the triangle APO and the triangle DMO, you will come to know that A angle P and angle M are the 90 degree according to our construction, and they are, and AOP and DOM are vertically opposite angles. So if that angles, all angles are corresponding angles are equal, then based on the theorem of similarity theorem, if all angles are equal, then the triangles are considered to be a similar. Okay, so that means, otherwise you can say that angle AAA similar criteria, we can say that APO and similar to DMO. Okay, yes, and also we have to prove that where AP is equal to AO and DM is equal to DO, then area of a triangle ABC by area of triangle DBC is equal to AO by DO. Just we have to observe carefully, then only you can understand that AP by and AO, AP by DM and AO by DO, they are the corresponding sides. Okay, in that way you can write this, you can prove this problem. Okay, let us first in fourth question. If the areas of two similar triangles are equal, prove that they are congruent. See, a congruent means they are having same shape and also same size. Concentration means only they are having same center, but not the area is totally different. So in that way, when you think, you that means you have to recall the meaning of the congruency, then you are able to answer this question. Okay, based on that given information and the area of a triangle theorem, I have written like this. According to that theorem, so AB is correspondent to PQ and AC is correspondent to PR and BC is correspondent to QR. So what we have to prove, that there are two areas, if the area is similar, the triangles are equal. So that you have to prove, no? Yes. Area of the triangle ABC is equal to area of a triangle PQR. So based on that one, okay, all are equal means that becomes one. The substituting the equation 2 in 1, so you will get 1 is equal to AB by PQ and whole square, and like that. So if you substitute, why we have written 1 means that areas are equal means if you divide them you will get a 1 only, no? That's why I have written like that. So based on that, when you cross multiply, So we will get that AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR and AC is equal to PR. So we can say according to the SSS postulate, so the triangle ABC is similar to the triangle PQR. Okay, in this way we have to prove this problem. Just only thing is we have to concentrate towards the picture, what we are going to write. Based on the information what they are giving in the problem, it becomes very easy for you to solve these type of problems. Okay, next let us move on to the question number 5. In this question, they have given this picture where D, E and F are respectively midpoints of two sides. They are respectively midpoints of two sides. So ABC and the CA of the triangle ABC, find the ratios of these triangles. This is the question they are asking here. So what we have to write now? So based on the information, that means data, DEF and also DEF, D, E and F are respectively the midpoint of the sides AB, BC and CA of a triangle ABC. What we have to prove? The areas of a triangle DEF and triangle ABC. Okay, based on this information, so we have drawn on this type of picture. Then we come to know that DE is parallel to AC. And then we can say that means half of AC. DEF is parallel to the AB. EF is equal to half AB, and then like that only we have to write according to the theorem number 6, that means areas of similar triangles. So I have written like this, and I got the answer, that is 1:4. That means in 1:2 ratio, the areas of triangle DEF and the area of a triangle ABC is dependent. Like that we have to write. Okay, next come to the next question, which is question number 6. Prove that the ratios of the areas of two triangles, similar triangles, is equal to the square of the ratios their corresponding medium. That is nothing but the areas of the similar triangles theorem statement it is. So like that only, that means after knowing that theorem, it is easy to explain, and also using this picture you can easily prove these things. Okay, so based on that information and whatever they are given, that means they have given that ABC is similar to PQR, then AD and PS are midpoint lines of a triangle ABC and also PQR. So if you draw like this, if you made a construction like that, that means perpendicular lines drawing to a base, so you can easily prove that things. So that the area of a triangle, if they are similar, similar, then their ratio of corresponding sides also becomes equal. So that's why based on that thing, I have written AB by PQ and BC by QR and AC by PR. So that means similarity triangle. Okay. So next one, afterwards, we come to know that angles are also equal. Then we can say that AD and PS are the midpoint lines. So then BD is equal to DC, and then BC by 2 we can say like that. So QS is equal to SR, otherwise you can say that it is half of the QR. Okay, by substituting all these things in the equation, okay, we will come to know that in triangle ABD and triangle PQS, where angle B is equal to angle Q, because they are the corresponding sides, corresponding angles of the triangles. So depending on that, when you write, when you recall BPT, otherwise the similarity triangle, their sides are proportional. So based on that statement, I have written the equation 3. Then again, when I have considered the triangle ABD and triangle PQS, According to SAS, that means side angle, side postulate, the fourth equation as written, and using the area of corresponding sides theorem number 6. So I have written like this, and I got it, the area of triangle BC and the triangle PQR is equal to AD by PS whole square. Yes, it is a very easy. Here we have to recall the similarity triangle theorem, and then if the angles are equal, corresponding angles are equal, the sides are proportional. That statement we have to recall, and that I have used to write first, second, and also third question, third equation, and then afterwards I substituted all that things in a fourth equation, then I got the answer like this. So this is the technique that we have to recall and you have to use. It becomes very easy. Okay, be careful while drawing that. Just we have to observe and read the questions properly. Okay, that will helpful to you in a more manner. Then they are asking in question number 7, prove that the areas of equilateral triangles described on one side of the square is equal to half of the areas of the equilateral triangle. That is the question they are asking. See this, look at this picture. Prove that area of equilateral triangles described on one side of the square. So you are observing that I have written one triangle on the one side of the square and is equal to the half of the areas of this equilateral triangle. Describe on one of its diagonal. So described another triangle I have written, which is where it has its base is on one of the diagonal, that is AC. So you can observe in the picture. This next one. So how they have given the information, that means data, the two triangles are equilateral triangles and AB is an AB of square on a side AB of a square ABCD and another triangle ACE ACF is on the diagonal AC. This much they are given and we have to prove that the area of the triangle ABC is equal to half of the area of a triangle ACF. Yes, how to prove that? Yes, we have to recall theorem number 6, which is related to areas of the ratios of areas of the triangles is equal to square of the ratios of the corresponding sides. Yes, when you recall that, you can write this equation like this, and then after substituting that values, why I have written AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square? Because you know that. That is the, when you consider any triangle, that means according to that right angle triangle, when you consider a triangle ABC, AC becomes a hypotenuse side. So that's why instead of AC square, I have written AB square plus BC square. Yes, next Pythagoras theorem after Pythagorean that I have written, and then we come to know that AB square is equal to 2AB square. How it is possible? Because ABCD is a square, that's why all sides are equal. So based on that property of a square, so I have written BC, instead of BC I have written again AB, then it has become 2AB square. Okay, yes. Next, afterwards, so AC sides, then after substituting all that things, so you will come to know that area of a triangle ABE by triangle ACF is equal to 1 by 2. That means half of that one. That is ACF is 2 times of AEF, AEB, sorry. So like that you have to think. Yes, another question is there. Here they are asking you to tick the correct answer. So what is the take? How to take ABC and the triangle BDE are 2 equilateral triangles. That means all sides are equal, such that D is the midpoint of BC and the ratio of areas of triangle ABCD and BDE is. And they have given 4 options, 2 is to 1, 1 is to 2 and 4 is to 1 and 4th option is 1 is to 4. In that I have written answer 4 is to 1. Then the question rises, how it is possible and how you have written, you will ask the question. For that, whatever the information that they have given, no, that I have drawn this diagram in different way also, so many people will draw, and after observing that, you can also say that like this. Yes, next one. See what I have written according to the theorem number 6. That means ratio of areas of the similar triangles is equal to ratio of square of corresponding sides. So based on that and the information what they have given, I have written like this. Then I got the answer 4:1. Like that you have to solve and get the answer. Okay, next come. Next question. That is 9th question. They are saying that sides of two similar triangles are in the ratio 4:9. Areas of these triangles are in the ratio of 2:1 or 4:9 or in 81:16 or 16:81. They are asking if two triangles are similar with area 4:9. That means corresponding sides are of measure 4:9, then what will be the areas of these triangles that you have to mention in a ratios? Let us see what which is the answer. Yes, that is 16:18. How that questions will rise? By using these things, you can easily calculate by analogy, otherwise that ratios, proportionality, that what you have learnt in the previous classes. Now, by using that idea, you can easily calculate that. Okay, 4:9. That means theorem number 6 based on that one. So, I have calculated 16:81. That is the ratio of the areas of the given triangles whose areas are 4:9. Next. So, according to this, I hope you have understood all the questions which are in the exercise 2.4. All the best. Read well and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.